Hello and welcome back to Pemblum Farm. Today we're going to get back to our cows and get them fed. They need a couple of loads of mixed ration, so we're going to get to feeding them that. We just need to pick up a couple of bales. Oh, wait. There we go. There we are. That's the first one. Get that into our feed trailer. So yeah, we need to do a couple of loads of this. Some hay. Get hold of that then. There we go. So it is April the 10th. We've not done a huge amount yesterday. At this point, it's mainly getting on with just making sure everything is good and sprayed and everything. We're probably going to go and do a bit more work for some other people, I think, in the next couple of weeks. We've been asked by a couple of our neighbours to do some stuff. So we're going to cracking on that, because our farm is actually running smoothly at the moment. Bash the stacks of bales, and yeah, it's going okay. It's basically doing this job every day, making sure that our animals are all fed. Right, we will just jump out of this for a moment. I won't worry about turning the power off quite yet. We're not going to be very long before we're back. There we go. Right, let's get alongside this. We need to muck them out as well. Yeah, I need a top up. There we go. And go get us another load. Then we need to do two or three loads of this. So, thankfully, with everything nicely close, it doesn't take too long. This is the last job of the day today. And you see the sun is setting. There we go. are getting to the point though where we need to get some more bales done. Well, we have only, we'll have only 3 hay bales left after this, and 4 silage, so we've got to, but we have plenty of grass fields once our grass is grown. So we can rectify that soon. Get our spring cut done. Just waiting for the grass to grow at this point. We should have enough feeds to keep our cows going while we are while we do that. There we go. Might do one more round after this again. There we are. So let's get into here. I want to get a as close as I can to it. Hello. You're queuing up waiting. There we go. Right, let's head back one more load. Seems to be going really well this. Then I think it might be time to muck them out, so we'll get hold of, we might have to go and buy a new piece of kit for this, I think, because I don't think we have anything for the Merlot here. There we are. Oh, have we done that? The bale wraps got stuck together. Let's see if we can't free this. Yeah, there we go. Get hold of it higher up. That freed it. First thing about that is you're driving along and suddenly it drops off the bottom. There we go. That's the first bit. Yeah, we are getting low. I'm hoping we can get some work done with some bales before I have to go and purchase some more, because I really don't. Buying bales is expensive. Okay. And we're down to our last 2 hay bales. Well, let's get the lights on. Light is fading fast now. Okay, just need a straw bale. I think we're going to have to go down to the shop with this and grab a manure fork. Let's clear this out. And we can, and we need to get the little tractor. I don't know where the trailer is over here. Excellent. So that's good. There's an easy way to do this. So that's what we're going to do. Right. We'll park this up because, we don't need to do any more of this. Leave that here for now. We're going to have to pop down to the shop with Merlot and see if we can't get a new piece of kit. So I might go to the house and order it. And then it should be delivered and ready down there in a moment. Right. There we go. Yeah, we do have a pile of manure to get out of that. Maybe an easier way to do it, actually. With the trailer. I need to do it now though before the shop shuts. Okay. Park this up. Go. Right, we don't need the Massey for now. Well, we don't need this Massey certainly for now. So I'll just put this back in the shed quickly. There we are. Right, I'm just gonna head to the back to the car and give the shop a call. Okay, so I've called the store and they do have a manure fork for us, so we're going to pop down there as they're due to close soon, so we want to get there before that happens. We'll take the Merlot because that's what we've got the manure fork for. So dropped, pumped off. Down that. We'll put our beacons on because we're taking this on the road. And away we go. So this will allow us to clean out the cows quite quickly and hopefully clean out the pigs as well. Although the pigs, we actually have a manure fork for the other for the little Massey for doing the pigs, so we got this really so we don't have to keep bringing the little Massey back up to the farm and have all its implements up here when really that little tractor is we have that more for managing the pigs than the cows or the sheep. church bell is going off. Alright, there we go. Here's the, there it is. There's it is waiting for us. This is a fairly large one. There we are. Back. I'm going to clear out the cows. That'll be another job, which is perfect. We'll get this done today. We won't have to worry about it later. While we waiting for the grass to grow, I think we'll probably go and do a little bit more contracting. So there's another field I'm interested in. What was on the plans is field 16. It's down by the pigs. That's not it. It's down by the pigs, and yeah, that's another good arable field I'm interested in adding to the farm. So I need to go and do some work with that, and hopefully help out. So there we go. I'm hoping I can tip this over the wall rather than having to drive around, because if I have to drive around, I'm going to have to leave the gate open. I don't really want, at the end of the day, to have escaping cows. Plus, the gate opens in the direction where it's in my way for doing this job. So, yeah. I would prefer not to. But looking at that, I'm not going to be able to. That is annoying. Right, so what I'm going to do, is can't do that, I am going to get the trailer and the tractor. So I'll leave this here for a moment. I don't think any of the cows are going to drive it off. Back over here, there we go. Use the little Massey and get it hooked up. I think it's got the pallet forks on. We want to drop those off. Don't need those. Did I just disconnect? Well, so we'll just put this here. Right, let's get our trailer. I need to go to get the lights on. Quite dark all of a sudden. Fortunately, I don't have to fight the light too much with this. around here. Now if we line this up right, we can get the trailer quite close. There we are. Right. There's not enough space to open the door fully. I'm getting stuck. There we go, that pulls us a little bit away. Let's try that. There we are. Let's fall over here. And back into the mallow. Oh, hello Daisy. There we go. Don't need those on anymore. See, it's quite a big. Come on past then. Oh, girl. Mucked out fairly quickly with this, I think. Got it. That's got it. Excellent. Oh, they're all coming in. They've all decided it's soft side. Perfect. Right. There we go, that's all done. There's not a cow, well, there are cows behind me, but I can avoid them. There we are. Right, let's get this out of here. There we go. Park this up and then we will run back and get the door closed. And off, there we go. Close up the gate. Right, let's go tip this manure. Not very far we have to take it, that's far enough. There we go. It's also not a huge pile of manure. Right. I think that's a good place as any to end. So I'm going to turn the camera off now. But before I go, all that remains is for me to say thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this video from Pembleham Farm. Please give it a like, drop us a comment and give it a share. And for all the latest videos and much, much more, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.